Almost in every web application or personal portfolio website, you'll be able to see this slide up multi-text animation. It's quite popular. So in this video, with the help of POCSS, I'll show you how to build this slide up multi-text animation. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsar with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. Let's create index.html file. Inside that, if I type exclamation sign and hit that tab button, then you'll get this basic HTML code. For the title, I'm giving POCSS slide up multi-text animation. Now within the body tag, let's create div with class name wrapper. Within that, let's create h1 heading with class name content, and I'm writing let's learn. Next to that heading, let's create paragraph tag. If I write lorem 16 and if I hit tab button, then you will get this dummy text. Similarly, next to that, let's create button and I'm writing get started. Now within the h1 heading, I want to create order list. Within that, let's create different list items. Within list item, I'm creating span tag and I'm writing UI/UX design. Let's duplicate the same code, and instead of that UI/UX design, let's keep web design. Now in order to save some time, I'm just copying and pasting these codes. Nothing much more is going on. I'm just changing different text. Now with the help of live server extension, let's open this index.html file in our default browser. As you can see, this is the result. Now we need to give some proper style. So for that, let's create a style.css file. And next to the title tag, let's give link for our style.css file. Now within the style.css file, in order to prevent browser's default margin and padding, font family, for the universal selector, I'm giving different margin padding as well as font family. In your browser, you can see some changes. Now let's style body tag. I'm giving minimum height of 100 vh. Let's give background. I want to give image. So within the URL, let's give background.jpg file. For the background position, I'm giving center, and if I give forward slash, then you'll be able to give background size. I'm giving cover. I want to make it a bit dark, so let's give background cover. I'm giving this black color with alpha value. Now you won't be able to see any changes, so if I give background blend mode to multiply, then now you can see you'll be able to get that dark background image. Now let's style this div with class name wrapper. So for the class wrapper, let's give text color to white, and I want to give some padding. Let's give 2 rem, and also I want to give position of absolute, and if I give top to 20%, now you can see our content, it is brought a bit down. Now let's style that paragraph. So for the paragraph, I'm giving width of 55 viewports width. Similarly, for the margin top and bottom, I'm giving 1 rem. For the left and right, 0. And also, I'm giving font weight of 300. Now, let's style that button. For the button, I'm giving padding top and bottom to 0.8 rem. For the left and right, 1.6 rem. And also, let's change that background color to crimson. For the text color, let's give white color. And also let's remove that border. For that, I'm giving border to none. And also I want to give some rounded corners. For that, let's give border radius of 2 rem. And also let's change that font size. I'm giving 1 rem. Okay, this is perfect. Now let's style this h1 heading with class name content, and also this order list. Now for the class content, I'm using font shorthand property. So for the font weight, I'm giving lighter. For the font size, let's give 3 rem. And for the font family, let's give Poppins sans serif. And also now you can duplicate the same code and bring it down. Now let's style order list. Let's remove that numbers. For that, let's give list style to none. Similarly, let's declare CSS variable height, and I'm giving 3.8 rem. Now for the actual height, let's give the same CSS variable height. And also for the line height, I'm giving the same CSS variable height. So with the help of this code, I'm trying to bring this text vertically centered. So if I give overflow to hidden, now you can see you'll be able to get only first list item. So now let's tell this span tag that is within our list item. For that, let's duplicate the same code and bring it down there. So now you can give their list item and you can select this code and duplicate it. So now for the span tag that is within our list item, let's give font width to 600. And also if I give hyphen webkit hyphen text fill color to transparent. And if I give background color to linear gradient. So for the angle, let's give 20 degree. For the first color, I'm giving sine, and for the second color, magenta. So this is not enough. Now you need to give extra another CSS property. So with the help of that, you'll be able to give gradient background color for our text. So I'm writing hyphen webkit hyphen background clip. So let's give text. Okay, there's no any changes, so there must be some error. Yeah, I did some mistake there. Whenever you are giving that linear gradient, at that time it's not background color, so that is just background image. So let's remove that color. Did you see that? Now you'll be able to get that linear gradient color text. It's looking pretty cool. Now it's time to give the animation. You know, we need to slide up each and every list items that is within our order list. So for that, now for the list item, let's give the animation. I'm giving animation name to slide up. For the duration, let's give 2ms. The reason for giving their 2ms is because, as you can see, we do have 6 different list items. So I'm giving their 2ms. That means for each individual list item, I'm giving 2ms. So that total makes 2ms. Now for the animation iteration count, let's give infinite. Now we have to give different keyframes. So for that, I'm writing at keyframes. Let's give the animation name. So in our case, that is slide up. Now at 0% and 10%, let's give transform. I'm giving translate y to 0%. And now you can select this code and duplicate it. Now let's change that 0% to 15% and 10% to 25%. Now at the time, we have to change this translate y 0% to -100%. Now once again, you can select this code and duplicate it. Instead of that 25%, let's give 30%, and also let's change it to 40%, and at 30% and 40%, I'm giving translate y to -200%. But you can see there is some problem with our animation. So what's wrong? Let's check out. If I comment this overflow to hidden, you can see our game development list item, it is breaking the line. So let's uncomment that overflow. And now in order to prevent that, for this span tag, you can give something like white space to no wrap. Now you can see it's working pretty good. Once again, you can select this code and duplicate it. Now at 45% and 55%, you can change that translate y to -300%. And once again, you can select this code and duplicate it. Now at 60% and 70%, I'm giving translate y to -400%. And for the last time, let's select this code and duplicate it.
No, God, please, no, no!
At 75% and 85%, let's change that translate y to -500%. Now you can see we did add 6 different keyframes because there were 6 different list items. But whenever you are adding some extra new list items, or whenever you are removing at that time, based on your number of list items, you have to give the same number of proper keyframes. So you may add or remove different keyframes. Okay, now by pressing F11 key, let's take our browser to the full screen. Now you can see this beautiful text slide of animation, and that all was done with the help of POCSS. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already ate, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.